a significant proportion of the chemotherapy drugs or the chemotherapy combinations we use do make the immune system to slightly go down. And that might become a fertile ground for the coronavirus to impact or infect these immunosuppressed or immunocompromised patients. We now have various investigations and tests. Like for instance, there's a test which was made in India called as the CanAssist, which tells us that breast cancer patients, all of them, need not go for chemotherapy.
Wow.
Now, this is a test which actually, once a patient gets surgery for CA breast, for cancer breast done, almost always we end up giving them chemotherapy for 4 cycles, sometimes 6 and sometimes 8 cycles. We also have a subset of breast cancer, which is hormone receptor positive, where simple hormone tablets can possibly work as good as chemotherapy.
Yes, that makes it a lot easier.
Yes, and quite some time back, you had no tools to identify which are those patients where we can avoid chemotherapy and still get all the benefit what chemotherapy does. When chemotherapy is not going to work, taking chemotherapy does not make sense. Now, these tests and tests like CanAssist tell you that which patients of breast cancer need not take chemotherapy. They get score in that and then tell us that this patient doesn't need chemotherapy. He can just go on to get a simple tablet like hormone therapy and still have no problem at all in the longevity. So number one, the chemotherapy is not as toxic as it seems to be. Number two, we have substitutes to intravenous chemotherapy and still as effective. And number three, you can avoid chemotherapy altogether by these special tests like CanAssist, which essentially talk about the mood of the nation in that we are Atmanirbhar in having this test available to us.